live. How you all going? Happy Friday night. Just bringing the iPad up so that we're all logged in. Hi guys, how you all going? Good to see you. Jazz, what are you doing here? I thought you'd still be on your day. Are you in the toilet? Thanks, Liam. Hi, April. Hi, Heidi. Hello, everyone. Welcome. We'll just give everyone a few more moments to join, otherwise they'll miss the introduction. Oh, I didn't realize you were home. Okay, we're going to have to chat about this after. Okay, so I'm logged on. I'll be able to see all your questions. Tonight, I have poured myself a beautiful glass of the Becklin Shiraz. This one. As you know, it's one of the three top wines that I always talk about and have offered you guys discounts and things too as well, just because I love supporting local. I love finding cool, amazing businesses that are at the top of their game in their craft, just really good at what they do. Thanks, Heidi. just really good at what they do. And if I love it, I'm going to support it and share it far and wide. That's what makes the world go round. So as you know, Becklin Wines in Currency Creek in South Australia has always been up there with, I have really three favourite winemakers in South Australia and lots of others, but three top ones. And I'm enjoying their new 2019 Shiraz tonight. Their 2018 is sold out after they won gold at London Wine Show. Yes, it's amazing. These guys are so, so good at what they do. And I reached out to Rebecca this week and I said, oh, it's just horrible what's going on in Victoria at the moment. We've all been there, but not as severe, and it was awful, and we're all feeling a lot better because we're coming out the other side, albeit a little bit afraid that we could slip back that way too. But it's just heartbreaking what's happening in Victoria at the moment. We know what it feels like. It's isolating, it's demoralizing, you feel downtrodden, especially because with Corona, the one thing that we haven't always had is an end date. And that's really tough. Any mental health professional will tell you that that's one of the most taxing things on us mentally, is not knowing when the end of something that's not so pleasant is going to be near. Often when you know that the end is coming, it lightens the load, it makes it a lot easier. So we know how tough this is. So I reached out to Rebecca from Becklin Wines and I said, hey, I want to send a little care package over to someone in Victoria. Let's just let any of our followers decide who it is. Anyone can comment to win, but the delivery address has to be in Victoria. So anyone from any state can win the prize and have it sent to a loved one in Victoria, or you personally can win the prize for yourself in Victoria. And she was all about it. She loved the idea. She jumped on straight away. So we've teamed up to have 6 bottles of this beautiful, beautiful Shiraz. $45 a bottle it retails for, I'm pretty sure. So it's top-notch wine. We're not talking, you know, a $20 bottle here. This is really, really great South Australian Shiraz. 6 bottles will be sent direct to the nominated address, nominated recipients, whether you're Victorian or not. If you win it, it goes to a Victorian address. So it will go to that person, and a $100 Miko and Mollie voucher. So the way you enter, if you haven't already, is find the post on our Instagram feed. It's a photo of the Becklin Shiraz and a cheese platter in my courtyard, actually. it's because I genuinely do enjoy this wine. And tag 3 friends, and every comment with 3 tags in it goes into the draw. It'll be randomly drawn next Sunday night, and both Rebecca and I will dispatch our prizes on the Monday. So, pending the winner getting in touch with us and giving us the address they're going to. So, that's so cool. Rebecca and I are both really proud to do something super cute like this. Just generate a bit of goodwill and happiness amongst Victorians. So, get around it, guys. We need more stuff like this in life, don't you think? So that's that. Cheers to you guys. Cheers to Rebecca from Becklin Wine. She's such a good egg and I'm so proud to have made such a beautiful connection with her. She's always looked after me personally with my wine because I shop with her myself. And she always gets behind a good cause as well. So she's fab. So cheers, guys. Friday night, we made it. I wasn't sure we were going to at some points during this week, but we got there. So that's what I'm drinking. So good. Just what I needed, honestly. Just what I needed. Yay. So that's a little bit of how... Oh, what's happened to my face there? Calm down, ring light. There we go. So that's a little bit of housekeeping, our little competition that we're running. So fun. My outfit tonight, we always run through that as well. I am wearing, we had a brand new Camilla drop this week, which is so exciting. We always love when the new Camilla arrives. So, so beautiful. This stuff is so beautiful. Silk, amazing prints, amazing embellishments. Does it get better? It just doesn't get better than that. So I'm wearing the new print, it's divine, so much navy and gold and just fab, called 7 Day Weekend. So I fell for it for that reason as well. How good is it to be able to put on a piece of clothing that makes you feel like you should be having a 7 Day Weekend? So I just pretend. I threw this on today and I'm like, yeah, you know, Friday, just a lead into the weekend, right? So I've been feeling really good today. So I'm wearing the 7 Day Weekend, look at that, T-back singlet and the wrap front trouser. Love, love, love these guys. Have been waiting for a pair of these pants to come back into the store for so long. I ordered so many extra pairs so that I could nab one without worrying about stealing any from customers. So I'm so stoked to have this set back in my wardrobe. I haven't had a set like this in a couple of years, so I'm really, really excited. And I've also paired it with our brand new label, Second Skin, Australian small business. And they custom make leather goods, beautiful leather goods, right here in Australia, I believe. When I was talking to them, it said in-house. So I'm presuming that means they make their goods right here in Australia. But we will confirm that for you. I'm sure there's probably someone from the agent or the team watching tonight. So guys, if you are here, please let us know, confirm. But yeah, look at these details. This is the Blake biker jacket. This is all custom made. There's a wait time of about 3 to 4 weeks, sometimes a bit less. Look at that. Isn't it just stunning? Oh, I'm obsessed. Now, and I'm wearing a Camilla boot. So that leads me into our discussion tonight about, I put a lot of time and thought into this and I wanted to give you guys, now I know a lot of you guys are like practiced fashionistas, you don't need help in this department, you're all over it, you look fab all the time, but there's a lot of people that are part of our family and follow along with us that don't have as much in their wardrobe to play with or at a point in their wardrobe journey where they're looking to pull it all together. Out with the old, in with some really good investment pieces that actually help bring together a nice, beautiful, cohesive wardrobe that makes them feel amazing. So that's what this session is mainly for. This is back to wardrobe basics. Instead of just flying blind and wildly buying things, and let's be honest, we all do that. We all get caught up in the hype of fashion and buy amazing things. But sometimes you're not doing your wardrobe justice. You're just adding all this stuff to your wardrobe and not making your wardrobe any more functional or any more cohesive or any more stylish, to be honest. Just random pieces here, there, and everywhere that don't make beautiful outfits. That's not helping you. So I wanted to go right back to basics and give you my top 5 wardrobe staples. Now, these are not high trendy fashion items that are just like, oh guys, buy these. I'm talking staples. I'm talking 5 items that if you have these 5 items in your wardrobe, they will make amazing stylish outfits with pretty much everything in your wardrobe. That is what a wardrobe staple is, and that's what we're talking about tonight. These do have a winter flair to them, because your staples do change from season to season, and you'll see what I mean when we start to get into it. For example, footwear. The footwear you wear during winter season is very different to what you wear during spring and summer. So this is our winter edition, top five staples, and I will do an update of this as we head into spring, summer, with the little differences. But a few of these staples will still carry right through. They're really great investments for your wardrobe all year round. So, in no particular order, because I personally believe all five of these things need to be in your wardrobe, guess what? You only need to buy them once. For most of these things, you only need to buy them once. If you love them that much, and there's some of them, there's lots of different variations of them, so you could buy two or three over time. But for most of these things, if you buy one, good quality, really think through your investment and purchase well, you are going to have a banging wardrobe very, very soon, that will add a lot more functionality to the stuff that's already there as well. And you know that's what we're all about, guys. We're not about waste. We're not about just spending all the money. I know I say this all the time, that makes us so terrible at our jobs, but we're also environmentalists at the end of the day as well. And also I have an economics background, so I'm a bit of an economist. And I do think that we need to be fiscally responsible. So it's about being environmentally and fiscally responsible, and not just buy and not get the wear and value out of them. And you know how I feel about fast fashion, that last 3 months, you hate it, you never wear it anyway because it cost you $30, so it's got no value to you, so you toss it aside really easily and it ends up in landfill. No fast fashion. I hate it. And I don't hate too many things in life, but I hate fast fashion. It's not worth spending your money on and it's really bad for the environment. So, into it we go. No particular order, because I believe these are five staples for a winter wardrobe. And we'll start off with this massive pile behind me here, because I think top thing number one, and we've all seen this year, it has been a bitterly cold winter this year for anyone basically not in Queensland. But I'm sure the Queenslanders have felt it as well, but just not to the extremes that we have in, say, Adelaide and Melbourne. It has been so cold. It started early. It's probably going to run late. We're having a long, cold winter this year, which just means your winter wardrobe, you're going to get more bang for your buck. You're going to get more wear out of it, which is awesome. So number one for tonight, but like I said, no particular order when it comes to whether or not I think these should be in your wardrobe, is a long winter coat. So we're talking like mid-length or knee-length coat, because it is going to add so much versatility to your wardrobe. All the things that you've been wearing in spring and summer and autumn, you can wear in winter as long as you have this coat and the appropriate footwear. Seriously. This is what I mean about staples. And it's hard to show you on a video, but you'll see in the blog post that we put up tomorrow when we do flat lays and things, I'm gonna show you how you can make everything in your wardrobe really, really versatile with these five items. So top tip number one is a long winter coat that's weather appropriate, that is actually warm. Some of the best ones we've seen this season have been Unreal Fur. They are seriously so toasty warm. There has not been a single time where I've needed to go outside in this super cold weather that I haven't been able to make any outfit weather appropriate by throwing on one of these jackets and looking stylish. Now, prior to this year, I actually hadn't nailed that. I hadn't come across a solution for winter dressing that looked amazing, but actually kept me warm. And I'm a bit of a cold fish and I hate to be cold. Sometimes it comes down to, I'm not going to go out tonight. I'll bail on my friends because it's too cold and I don't want to sit around feeling cold. Have not had that problem this year in any of my Unreal Fur coats. And that is why I have at least six of them. And I know that sounds excessive, but it's not. Not for me, when it has meant I have stayed toasty, toasty warm this winter and always looked amazing. So to me, it was worth it. 100%, 100% worth it. So that's one of the key staples for a winter wardrobe. It's gonna help you get lots more versatility out of everything you've bought pre-winter. There's no reason why it can't still be worn. It should still be worn. It just needs a winter coat. So, for example, some of the ones that we've been loving. Now, there's no leopard coming in the next Unreal Fur collection as far as we've seen. And I have seen the lookbooks and promotional materials, but unless they have a couple of sneaky ones that we haven't seen yet, there's no leopard in the next collection, which devastates me because this year I've become such a leopard print fan just because I've seen it in practice and it looks unreal. It's so suave and sophisticated, but it's hard-hitting fashion as well. Like, I'll be wearing these with sneakers and my work clothes on my walk into work on the one day a week that I actually go to work. And people stop me on their walk with their iPods in and their running shoes on and whatever, gas bagging along, and these women will stop me and go, "Great coat!" And I'm like, "It is a great coat, thank you." So we are absolutely loving the leopard Unreal Fur coats. Now, very, very poor, helping on my part tonight because there is only extra small and small left in these coats. Like I said, they have been so on fire this season. That's literally all that's left in these. But if you happen to be an extra small or a small, you need to get these leopard coats into your wardrobe. They're amazing. The difference between the two, the lighter leopard, so there's a color difference. The lighter leopard is slightly longer and the darker leopard is slightly shorter. Both still long line coats though, both just as fab. I thought I'd only need one and I bought both because they are awesome. So I love, love, loving those. We've also been loving the premium rose. We are also still getting down to our last few sizes in these ones as well. This one is coming back in the next collection in a dip. Is it? No, it's not. This long line one's not coming in the next collection. The fur, the shorter version, Fur Delish, is, but in a different color. So if you're loving this natural color, which to be honest, I have found goes with absolutely everything, you need to get this in your wardrobe before it sells out. The other one we've loved has been the exact same style, the premium rose in the deep teal for something different. We talked about this at the start of the season, and I was talking about how much I love it for something different. But as the season wore on, you would have heard me banging on about how much this color goes with. It's mental. So that's really good buying as well. And then the new Unreal Fur range at the moment, so they've released the capsule at the moment, which is the shearling or shearling. I've never learned how to say it because it's baby lamb skin. The skin and everything, it's horrible. Not with Unreal Fur though. Unreal Fur is a cruelty-free organization. It's all vegan. So this is faux shearling or shearling or whatever it is. And this is actually so fab. Really, really cool look, a real fashion vibe, like a real it girl vibe about it, because it's something a bit different that not everyone's wearing, despite the fact that shearling or shearling has been so hot for a couple of years now. So loving that one. And then the only other long line coat that I don't have on me at the moment is a P Nation trench. So the P and any trench really, trench coats. So faux fur, long line coats and trench coats, gotta have at least one of them in your wardrobe. That's top tip number one that we're talking about tonight. Staple number one. Staple number two, leather jacket. Don't care what style, you have to have a leather jacket. So we've gone from your long line jacket where you really need protection from the weather. Now we're going to more of a basic jacket that can go over everything and caters for less extreme temperatures. But probably, you know, if I went out of an evening when it was 6 or 7 degrees, just wearing, say, my Camilla and a leather jacket, I'm going to freeze. That's when I'm going to be looking for my long line faux fur or trench coats to really block out that chill. But for the rest of winter, the leather jacket is going to bring so much life into your wardrobe. Whether it's spring, summer, winter, autumn clothes in your wardrobe, chuck on a leather jacket and some ankle boots, which we'll talk through in a moment, and you've made that outfit winter appropriate. So a good quality leather jacket is worth its weight in gold. They are always an investment piece, but generally you'll have them for 10 years or more, especially if you look after them well. And we have written a blog post on leather care before, and it's probably about time I reposted that. But yeah, a good quality leather jacket's really, really important. We are loving the biker one at the moment for something a little bit different. Obviously, Biker has been around forever and a day. It's a really, really classic car. But this is the new one for us in this beautiful buttery leather, and we're absolutely loving it. Really good price point. The second skin jackets are around the $600 mark from memory. Whereas obviously we've had Sass & Bide leather jackets and things in the store in the past, and they're around $1,000. So, and I mean, I think this is much better quality and much more wearable and more timeless, way more timeless. So these are a much better investment in my personal opinion. And that's staple number two. A good quality leather jacket has to be in your winter wardrobe to create so many outfits for you. So that's staple number two. Staple number three for winter wardrobe is a great quality pair of ankle boots. I'm not going to bang on about this one too long because we actually did a Frock Up Friday on this a couple of months ago, and I banged on about how I love ankle boots and that I wait all year to wear them. They are so winter appropriate. You can wear them into the shoulder seasons, autumn and spring, but you can't wear them in summer. It looks a bit silly. Like in a 38 degree day, if you're rocking around in a good quality leather ankle boot, just doesn't quite look right. But definitely like a cute mini dress and an ankle boot and a leather jacket in spring, amazing. And of course, autumn is the same as winter really dressing, so everything looks appropriate. So yes, ankle boots. They are so stylish, they are so warm, they keep your feet warm and dry, and they're so winter appropriate. So staple number three for your winter wardrobe is ankle boots. And you know we love Senso. Senso is right up there. And sorry, when I say ankle boots, I mean a statement ankle boot. So that's what's gonna bring some oomph to your wardrobe. We're talking about two things here: helping make your wardrobe cohesive and make really cool outfits. From these five items, I'm guaranteeing you they're gonna make some great outfits in stuff you've already got in your wardrobe. But we're looking for a statement piece as well, because we want stylish outfits. There's only so many days in our lives, guys. Do not waste a single day of your life in a bad outfit. Unless it's pajamas, I'm okay with that. I'm okay with a whole day spent in pajamas. I've been doing it a lot lately. But any other time, great outfit or no outfit, seriously. You know what it does for us mentally. It makes us feel so good about ourselves. You almost take on a different persona, the best version of yourself, the queen who doesn't care what other people think, who's confident in herself and her abilities, who feels good about herself. That is why we do it. And this is why I'm giving you these tips on the five staples, because I want every outfit you step out of the house in to be a 10, an absolute 10. And these items will help you do that really easily, really, really easily. And every year, year after year after year. So as you know, these are our faves. We love the Senso shoes. These are mine, so they've got signs of wear on them. I wear them all the time, all the time. Good classic black, just a little bit of a heel, so super comfy. Really cute little metal ring pulls on the back. Remember we talked about how they've got a big lip on them so you can't scuff them? Senso, think of everything. If you're looking for another statement boot, still again Senso, the LaToya, this is statement. Love them. With a pair of jeans and a pair of t-shirt and a leather jacket. This leather jacket, amazing. Like seriously, this is what I mean. We've got the browns as well for you girls that wear more neutrals. But like I said, these will last. So buy black 1 year, brown the next year, statement the year after, and your wardrobe's going to be looking pretty good. And the other thing I wanted to show you guys was we got brand new delivery of Senso mules today. I know a lot of you have been waiting for these because I've been wearing them cheekily. Everyone's been going, what are those shoes? I need them. And I'm like, calm down, they're coming. And they're here. And to me, a mule is a really good alternative to an ankle boot in winter as well. They still have full coverage over the foot, so you're keeping warm and dry, but they're just a little bit dressier. Good for evening wear, good for really, but they've still got that funk factor that an ankle boot has as well. So we've got the Quinlan. Everyone loves these. I've been wearing these and people go crazy for them. And we got the brand new Quintessa today in tiger pony hair. How amazing are these? Super, super cute. They've got a stiletto heel, so again, slightly dressier, but still that real fun, crazy funk factor that Senso does so well and that we are so well known for. You know, when you saw these, you were like, yep, Miko and Mollie is definitely gonna get these cause they're crazy, crazy good. So that was a little bonus one. With ankle boots, you got mules as well. But a mule is great because it's also heading into a spring staple as well. Definitely can wear a mule into spring and summer too. So that's awesome. Next, so that's three staples. I'm doing this off the top of my head tonight. I didn't write any notes tonight. So now you'll see the difference between how well organized I've been the last few weeks and then when I'm back to just winging it. So the next key staple for winter, in my opinion, is a great leather legging or leather pants. This is Second Skin, again, same brand as the jacket. These are around the $469 mark, I think. People have been begging us for a leather legging for a couple of years, and we have not been able to find them. This is the first year where we've been able to get our hands on them again. So because people ask us for them so much, we know these are a staple for your wardrobe because they go with everything. Otherwise, people wouldn't be asking for them. And they literally do, and they give style and, you know, it girl factor to every outfit. Don't just throw on a normal pair of leggings or a pair of jeans when you could put on a leather legging and really take it up a notch. So a leather legging, in our view, is an absolute staple. And it can also turn a lot of your spring and summer dresses into winter outfits because you can just front tuck that spring or summer dress into the leather legging, throw a blazer or a long coat or a short coat over it, ankle boot, mule, away you go. So yeah, we're big fans of leather leggings. I'm so glad that we have a leather legging back in the store now because now I can go back to wearing mine. And they were an absolute staple for me before we sold out of them. Because you know, once we're sold out, I can't wear them because everyone asks for them and then I have to disappoint them and say, oh no, it's sold out. Like the PE Nation tracksuit today. I didn't even buy it, no point. I knew it was gonna sell out in hours and it did. And staple number five for your winter wardrobe, and this one's all year round, so you'll never go wrong investing in this piece, but it really does add some style and really completes the outfit. It's the difference between a half finished oil painting and a fully finished oil painting. And that is a really great bag, a classic bag, but with some statement to it as well, so that it still really polishes off the outfit and makes it look amazing. We love Dylan Kane. You guys know we love Dylan Kane. When I was overseas last year on my annual holiday, I was actually looking, I was going to treat myself to a designer handbag because I don't have one. And I was like, oh, you know, rather than buy trinkets and things like that that just weigh my suitcase down, I was like, well, I'm in the US, these brands are US, a lot of them. I'll buy myself one of these designer handbags and cool, like then it will be a nice little reminder of my trip. And I didn't because we already had Dylan Kane in the store. And I was like, you know what? I was actually traveling with a Dylan Kane bag at the time. I was like, you know what? These are such high quality. The leather's amazing. The details on them are amazing. And they're so classic and refined. And they're like a tenth of the price, like a tenth, 10% of the price of even your most basic designer handbag. So we're not even talking in the ones that are like, you know, super desirable and retail for like $9,000-$10,000. We're talking a standard designer handbag. These are a tenth of the price. So I came home without a designer handbag. I don't need them. I've got Dylan Kane. I love Dylan Kane. It's so, it's like the refinement to it and the way it finishes off an outfit is right up there with the designer handbags in my opinion. Well, it's just my opinion. What would I know? So I'm a big fan of my Dylan Kane handbags. I bought this one earlier this year when I was traveling. This is the LSC, really cute little one. It actually is magnetic and detaches. It hooks on the strap and this little decorative gold chain. Both hook them together for extra security so they can't be stolen off of you, and which is what makes it so great for traveling to some of those countries where that can happen sometimes. And there's a great length strap for a crossbody, really cute decorative strap, and I'm pretty sure it came with another strap as well. That's the thing with Dylan Kane, often they will come with two straps because they like them to be super versatile, and for you to play with them, let your own personality shine, but also be super versatile, so it can change with your outfit and the need for the bag at the time. So the LSC I absolutely love. It's a really cute little bag, fits everything in it. I fit keys, cards, money, phone, and I have that big one, big phone. Makeup, like a compact, and lipstick. There's actually normally three lipsticks in here, a bit of overkill, but I forget to take them out. So yeah, it actually fits quite a bit. The wax handbag, we absolutely love. This one's so cool. It's their beautiful leather again, but then it's accented with the crocodile print on the top as well. This one's a little bit dressier, but I love the fact that you can make the strap long and wear it as a crossbody bag. So that makes it a bit more like, this outfit's cute. I really like this as like a casual leaving the house to run errands or go meet my girlfriends for lunch or whatever outfit. But again, very versatile. If you had a function or something to go to, shorten the strap and you've got an evening clutch. Perfect. Love it. Bigger than the LSC, fits a fair bit. And then this one is the Lovette bag, with really cute details, really great leather, nice and big, fits the world in there. Who knows what I've got in there. This is a really great one that I finally found, a great handbag that looks stylish and fashion, but actually is a work bag for me. So I can run to and from work with all my stuff in it and then go out for drinks or dinner afterwards and my outfit still looks fashionable and amazing. So there you go, top five staples for your winter wardrobe. A lot of them will see you all the way through the year, except for your big heavy coats. It's only really winter in Australia where we need those. It doesn't really get that cold here the rest of the time, but they're a definite must have in winter. It's been bitterly cold this year, and I couldn't have survived without them. So a long line, good quality coat, whether it's a faux fur or a trench, those have been the two biggest this season, tipped to be pretty huge again next year. A good quality leather jacket, that's an all year round item for your wardrobe and will always help. You know, you could put a jumpsuit, a spring dress, jeans and a t-shirt, and put all of these things over it and they're the exact same thing, but they're gonna look amazing. So, you know, think of that in your head. Think of all the things you've got in your wardrobe at the moment, particularly things you probably haven't worn in 10 or 12 weeks, and think, how would they look with a long line faux fur winter coat or a trench and ankle boots and a great bag? Or the biker leather jacket, ankle boots and a great bag. All of your tops, your short dresses, your Camilla caftans, tucked into a great pair of leather leggings with a jacket, a great bag, and an ankle boot. You know what I mean? All of that stuff. These outfits are going to look absolutely amazing just from five winter staples that'll stay in your wardrobe for years and years to come. So it really is a lifesaver when you've got staples in you, and they're called staples for a reason. They're like pantry staples. It's like, these things here are your flour, your sugar, your butter, your eggs. If you've got that stuff, you can make anything. And they are really critical and will bring so much life back to your wardrobe with a stylish edge as well. You'll never have any of those moments where you're like, oh, I've got nothing to wear, when you've got staples in your wardrobe. So, I think my iPad's under all of these. that's it from me today. I didn't do too badly, given that I hadn't, you know, not scripted it all out, but guided myself through it with notes and was just doing it off the top of my head. 8:33, killed it. All right, I'm going to, you guys chat amongst yourselves like you do every week, and I'm going to quickly scroll through and see if you had any questions for me. Everywhere. week, I just laugh at your comments, and also like my heart is so warmed by the little things you say to me while I'm talking. You're so sweet. Thank you. Heidi, I'll check for you on the natural jacket. I will check as soon as we get off and get back to you. Good idea, by the way. We all need a good leather jacket, April. We definitely do. They save you so many times when you're in your wardrobe and you're like, oh, I've got nothing to wear. Pretty much anything under a great, well-cut, well-fitted leather jacket is going to look amazing. And you're a Camilla girl as well. I can't believe, like, a leather jacket and Camilla, job done. Hi, Jade. Great outfit or no outfit? Finally, the Muse! I'm so excited. Honestly, they rocked up this morning. I was like, yes! These particular boots, the Senso winter ankle boots, don't have a higher heel. Let me look into the range and see if I can find something for you. I think I steered clear of anything with a heel this season because they all seem to have a stiletto heel, which is not comfortable, not that great for your back and whatnot. And also just get stuck in the cracks. Like in winter when we're walking around sludgy, you want a block heel so that you're not sinking down into the ground all the time, or getting the little tip of the stiletto caught in the cracks of pavers and things and concrete and roads when you're walking along, because very quickly the back of your stiletto heel gets stripped and looks awful. And I hate that. And it's so wasteful as well. Like I was saying before, you spend $200-$300 on a great pair of boots with a stiletto heel, and within 2 weeks the back of it is stripped and ruined and it looks like you've had them for 45 years. So to me, I just they make me angry. Come up with a new solution, guys. Just all shoemakers, listen up. If we want a high boot, it doesn't have to be stiletto. But I'll look into that for you. I fold my leather leggings and no, they're fine. Also, if I do have, and I mean, if any of you follow my personal Instagram account, you would have seen my wardrobe from time to time. I am the worst at just opening the door and throwing things in there and forgetting about them for a week. So I always find a light steam. I'm not sure whether you're supposed to do that, so be very, very careful. Or a very, very cool iron does tend to, on the inside, not on the outside, does tend, and usually with a tea towel or something as well is great, will help you get a stubborn crease out if you have done something naughty to them. But generally, if you store them folded, and don't put jeans and stuff on top of them. If you're putting them on piles, put them on the top of the pile so that they don't get compressed. But storing your leather leggings and leather pants folded and on a shelf, no problem. You shouldn't have any problems with creases. Like I said, if you do get creases, don't follow my advice and steam or iron without knowing what you're doing, because you could be very upset. I leather condition everything, not very often, with every 1 to 2 years generally. But yes, I leather condition everything, including this couch. And I use the exact same product for all of them. But as we've discovered recently, not all leathers are created equal, and you do have to be really, really careful. Don't just slather a leather cleaner on or a leather conditioner on to anything, even if you've been using it for 10 years. Always spot test it in an inconspicuous place, and always wait at least 24 to 48 hours to see whether it's going to react on you. I love leather. I don't love the fact that it comes from cows, but I love it so much I can't actually give it up, even regardless of that fact. I'm sorry, vegetarians and vegans. I'm sorry, animals. Like, I just can't give, this is my one thing. I need it. I can't give it up. And steak. I'm a red wine drinker. What can I say? Steak and, I mean, red wine and vegetarian lasagna just doesn't quite have the same ring to it. Oh dear. Yes! Do you have your bag? P.S. I'm not going to sell you a night waiting for day belt bag if you're going to leave it behind on dates, okay? I'm just laughing at you guys. I love that, you too, Jazz. You guys are so funny. Rolling jeans is a great idea, Elise. And I think that would definitely work with leather as well, rolling them nice and gently. We have spoken about that. Is it so if you wear a belt bag, and I have to be careful with this top right now. If you wear a belt bag cinched in at the waist, I feel it's a belt bag. If you wear it slung down low on the hips, then yes, you're right, it's a bum bag. But at least it's not a fanny pack, as my US friends call it, which still makes me laugh. Yes, April, in Canada they call them fanny packs. It's like, why? As a child, I just did not get that until I went to the US and realized they actually call your bottom a fanny. It's not even a nice word. I don't know why. Oh, Deirdre, I'm with you on both of those. I will never wear a bum bag. Belt bag, yes. Around the waist, like I said, I'll be wearing mine around my waist or actually slung across my body. And stirrup pants, you will not catch me dead in stirrup pants either. And snap pants, when they came back a few years ago and all the Insta-famous people were wearing them, and I was like, I don't care how cool you guys are, I will never ever wear snap pants. Yes, Jess, that is what we call them here. Oh my god, you guys are so funny. You honestly make my night. Well, it doesn't look like you have any questions about my top five staples for creating a really stylish and cohesive winter wardrobe that brings everything together, creates lots of new outfits from the same things you've already got. Make sure new things you're adding to your wardrobe will be super usable and saves you money in the long run. These things are good investments that you'll be able to wear year after year and also season after season for most of them. So if you don't have any questions, we can finish up early and continue our chat after this, like most of us do every Friday night anyway. And I have to go and check that jacket for Heidi. Do you think, Anita, I never really got the YouTube thing. I don't know, is it like, does YouTube still happen? Would people actually watch this on YouTube? I don't know. Maybe I'll try it later down the track with all that spare time I have. you guys are amazing. This was so fun. Can't believe we nailed it so quickly and without any notes. Obviously, I believe in this stuff and it just came out really naturally. I honestly do believe that these 5 staples are really important. Oh, I nearly forgot, of course, your discount for tonight. You know the drill, Friends of Courtney, all one word, all capital letters. And this tonight, it's 15% off the entire site, no minimum spend, a couple of exclusions. So like brand new PE Nation releases and a couple of other things, I think from memory, but not much. Site-wide, 15% off. Go and grab yourself some winter staples. Get that versatility back into your wardrobe. Don't freeze, look stylish. And especially if you're looking, as we're heading into spring, still super high up in our top 5 staples for cohesive spring and summer wardrobes is a leather jacket. It is your mules. It is a great handbag. It is a leather legging. So the only thing, if you're not wanting to spend money on something that you'll only wear for another month and a half, maybe leave the heavy duty coat out of it and focus on the other 4 things, because you'll be wearing them all spring, summer too. So there you go. Friends of Courtney, 15% off, even all the new arrivals except for a couple. Enjoy. Don't think I've seen any more questions come through, so I think we're done. Have a great night, girls. Don't forget to share the competition so that we can send those 6 bottles of amazing Beckland wine, Shiraz, and a $100 Miko Mollie voucher to someone in need in Victoria who needs a bit of wine and online shopping to get through ISO. And I will see you all again next week for Frock Up Friday. And I think, what are we doing tomorrow? I mean, next week. It's actually how to style this one. Shearling coats or shearling coats, whatever they're called. I promise I will look up the pronunciation of that before next week so I don't embarrass myself any further. Night, guys. You're the best. Enjoy your Friday night. Mwah.